Well, it's time to bring it on with some of your email questions. And this first one, Gordon, is from Debbie, who says, my question is about speaking in tongues that cannot be interpreted. Is this evil or good? I was watching a Bible teacher, and he said that the speaking could not be if the speaking could not be interpreted, then it was from an evil source. Please clear this up for me.
Debbie, it's not from an evil source. The Bible is very clear about what happens when the tongue is not interpreted. It means the unbelievers in your midst are going to think you're crazy. So that's the result of it. Instead of saying it's from an evil source, pray, Lord, give me the interpretation. And he'll do that. He'll answer that prayer. He wants to give the gift of interpretation, just like he wants to give the gift of tongues.
Okay, this is Rachel, who says, scriptures mention women who are barren and the curse that accompanied that. With modern technology, it can be determined whether males are virile or females are barren. Was this a cultural idea that only pertained to women?
Rachel, you need to read all the scripture. There's plenty of scripture about men who are unable to have children. And if you read in the Torah, they are excluded from the assembly. They are not allowed to even be called a part of the nation of Israel. They are forbidden from ever marrying. So if you think there's a problem for barren women could marry. But a man who could not conceive a child, he wasn't even allowed to marry a woman. So it's not a double standard. It's the same standard for both. It was actually worse for the men. You may be caught up that the barren women are perhaps a little more famous. Sarah, Hannah, and in those instances, quite clearly, their husband could have children because they had children with other women. So that may be what you're caught up with. God's not having a double standard here. In fact, it was actually worse for the men. We leave you with these words from Luke 18. The things which are impossible with men are possible with God. Let me leave you with this thought. Start thinking, how big is possible? How big is God? And what does he want you to do today?